Okay, so we're continuing with the film from where we've just left off the last time we watched it. Now, if we just think back to the last time you watched this, we were in Drood's Bottom. Carrie and Nick had been to pick up the Christmas goose from Drood's Bottom. We'd met Mr. Johnny, which is the man you can see on the screen, and you'd also met Hepzibah. And we'd found out that Albert Sandwich, who was the evacuee with Carrie and Nick on the train, had been taken in by Hepzibah and Mr. Johnny into the house called Drood's Bottom, and they were living there looking after Mrs. Go-to-Bed. Now, Mrs. Go-to-Bed is Aunt Lou and Mr. Evans's sister, okay, elderly sister. And we found out in that episode that you've just watched that she's very, very poorly, and she is in fact dying. Now, also, we heard about a skull and the curse of the skull in that last episode that you watched too. Okay, I'm going to continue letting this play now, and then we'll come back to it to do our teaching. Okay, off you go.
Good.
Goodbye, Mr. Johnny.
Goodbye. Bye.
He said we must come back again. You didn't understand him. He said you were cross because I sat on Hepzibah's lap. You're too old for that sort of thing. It made you look silly. I didn't feel silly. I felt nice. Did you believe Hepzibah? About the skull? She doesn't seem the sort of person to make things up.
And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord shone round about them, and they were sore afraid. And the angel said unto them,
When can we open our presents? Mum and Dad, shall we?
Fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people.
Auntie Lou, they're great. The Bible's lovely, Mr. Evans. Thank you.
When you collected the goose, did you see my sister?
No, not really. She was upstairs in bed.
Was the house in good order?
We had a huge tea. The best I've ever had.
Better than yours, I suppose.
No, not really. What are you talking about? Hepzibah's mince pies. It wasn't that good. You know what Nick's like, he'll eat anything.
Oh, it's all right when you don't have to foot the bill, isn't it? Miss Hepzibah Green is very generous, but then it doesn't come out of her pocket. She doesn't have to sweat and slave for every penny.
Hepzibah's a very good housekeeper, Samuel. She's been very good to poor Dillis.
And why shouldn't she be? She's on to a good thing, and well, she knows it. A mistress too ill to keep her eye on the books. Did you see the idiot?
Mr. John, he's not an idiot. He's not. Why are you saying all this?
I'm not.
I think you're the meanest thing on this earth, Carrie Willow. Mean and ugly. Hepzibah gave us a delicious tea.
I didn't mean...
You're worse than he is. He's just nasty about everyone. But you're nasty about people you like.
What am I meant to say?
You're a traitor.
No, I'm not.
Go and tell him what you really think.
All right, I will.
You see if I don't.
That girl's got her head screwed on all right. Miss Green didn't take her in with her soft, smarmy ways. I tell you, Lou, this could work to our benefit. The girl can be our eyes and ears.
You can't ask her to spy, Samuel.
Spy? What sort of word is that? Hepzibah has some sort of power over Dillis. Our own flesh and blood. And well, you know it. Creeping around, up and down the stairs. I won't have it.
I only ever walk on the paint.
I wonder. Perhaps you and the boy could take a tin of biscuits over to Miss Green sometime. A little thank you for preparing the goose.
When the Gotobeds first bought this place, it was a huge estate, stretching for miles and miles.
Why were they so rich?
They had diamond mines in Africa and railroads in America. Did you know Mrs. Gotobed was in Russia when they had the revolution? She escaped at night to Paris, and then they lost it all.
How?
Oh, gambling and giving grand parties and travelling all over the world on huge ocean liners. All she's got left is a couple of fields and a few animals. They say it's a bottomless pit.
Mind yourself, Carrie.
I was just... We collected the eggs. Nick and Mr. Johnny.
Why don't you come and tell Mrs. Gotobed all about it? It's all right. She won't bite.
Sit here, pretty child, on the stool. Albert says you have the most beautiful eyes. Do you like my dress?
It's lovely.
Mm? My husband gave it to me just after we were married. In Paris. He bought me 29 ball gowns, one for each year of our marriage. I want to wear each one of them once more before I die. Pour the tea, child. I've got a green chiffon with pearls round the neck, and a blue brocade and grey silk with pink ostrich feathers. That was my husband's favourite. So I'll be keeping that one till last. Just a little milk in my tea. And two slices of bread, folded over.
Would you like jam? It's Hepzibah's blackberry.
No, child, no jam. So, you're my brother's evacuee. What do you think of my little brother? Do you like him?
Well, yes.
Then you're the only one who does. Cold, hard, mean man, my brother. What's he said about me? Have you come here as a spy?
No, I have not.
I think you and I, young lady, are going to get along just fine.
Glenn has come along specially today to meet you.
Thank you, Vernon, and hello to all you guys and gals on the all-allied fighting team.
And how do you feel about the British reaction to your American band of the AES?
Tommy's we played for it made us feel right at home. We were...
I need you to do something for me, Carrie. When I'm dead and buried, I want you to tell my brother that I hadn't forgotten him. My own flesh and blood. But that sometimes you owe more to strangers. I'm doing what I'm doing because it seems right. Not because I want to spite him. You understand what I'm saying, don't you? He'll ask you about me.
You want to know what I've told you?
I won't tell him. Until you're dead.
£1.05 and 6p. Half a crown.
Thank you, Carrie.
I'll put these things on order for you, Mrs. Jenkins.
Oh, it's so much easier asking you. I know if I asked Mr. Evans, he'd say, don't you know there's a war, Mrs. Jenkins?
He's at a council meeting at the moment.
I rather hoped he might be. Hello?
I wish your brother had your arithmetic, young lady.
But he can run faster than me.
The amount of trouble he gets into, he needs to.
How can I help you?
Is Miss Louisa Evans at home, ma'am? Major Harper. Major Cass Harper.
You're American.
Is Louisa here?
No, it's just me at the moment.
Well, do you mind if I wait a while?
Mr. Evans is coming back.
Miss Louisa's brother. Well, I'd be more than glad to get acquainted with him.
He hates American soldiers.
Well, I'm a very respectable American soldier.
Even if you did see her, Mr. Evans wouldn't let you go out with her. He says dance halls are the haunts of the devil.
Well, I know for a fact Miss Louisa doesn't altogether agree with her brother on that score.
Are you from Pennsylvania? You can't meet her here. He won't let you.
Well, would you tell her for me that I called by and I'm sorry I missed her?
Harper. The Red Lion. He wants to see you.
I can't go in. Mr. Evans.
He won't know if you don't tell him.
But there's plenty of will just to get back at him. Oh, look at me.
It doesn't matter. He seems too nice to worry about that.
He is, Carrie. He's really nice.
Where's your auntie?
It's been a lovely autumn evening. She went for a walk up the mountain. I said I'd get the supper. How's your son getting on in Africa?
He'll be home soon. Then you'll see what a fine boy he is.
Must you work so hard?
Oh, sympathy, is it? That's something I don't often get. As I say to Frederick, the only things worth having in life are the things you work hard for.
Was it nice up the mountain?
All right for Sam, isn't it? Messing and handbagging about all hours of the night. I tell you, Sam, this girl's a far better cook than you'll ever be.
Says you're queen for the day.
Come on.
Can we see the rabbits now?
Oh,
why didn't Auntie Lou live with Mrs. Go-to-Bed?
Mr. Evans wouldn't allow it. Go-to-Bed's led a bad life to his way of thinking.
Mrs. Go-to-Bed says that Mr. Evans is cold, hard and mean.
He's had a hard life. Nursed his wife through a long illness. No wonder Mr. Evans is bitter about those that have had it easy.
Like Mrs. Go-to-Bed.
I hope I'm never like that about Nick.
They're two of a kind. Peacock proud and stubborn with it. He'll never forgive her for the life she spent. And she won't let him see what she's come to at the end of it.
Hepzibah says the stream's got magical powers. Soak the flowers in the sacred spring and they'll last forever.
Do you believe that?
Hepzibah does. She uses this water to make her medicines. This whole place was sacred once. A grove, a mountain.
I think it still is. And it always will be.
Kerry. A happy birthday.
Thank you.
Girls don't usually say thank you when they get kissed.
My birthday. I'm queen for the day.
Also, it's you then.
No, it's the ancient wise woman from the sacred mountain. Come to tell your fortune.
To your room, boy. Liberty Hall. That's what you've made of my home.
Sorry. I told Auntie Lou we were going to see Hepzibah. We're not late.
Always going to see Hepzibah. All summer long. The same story.
It's only me and Nick ever go there.
Have you been invited, though? My sister's house, isn't it? Suits Miss Green all right. Out of sight, out of mind.
She's not shut away. She's just ill.
Oh, so you've seen her then? Why didn't you tell me?
I didn't think.
Didn't think? Didn't think what? My own flesh and blood and I'm not interested?
There wasn't anything to say.
Said nothing, did she? Sat dumb? No message for me, for her brother? What did she say to you? You will tell me. Lipstick?
Most women wear lipstick, Samuel. I didn't want to be any different when I go to the dance.
Dance?
at the camp, the American base down the valley.
Out! Now! Now wash your godforsaken face, girl. Get rid of that filth!
You're not my father, Samuel.
Don't answer me back, girl.
You have a secret, don't you, Carrie?
Louisa? Louisa!
I know you have a secret. I can tell. And so can Evans.
I won't tell him anything. I won't.
This came from Glasgow.
It's from Mum and Dad.
Bonfire. Mrs. Gotobed wants it done.
But you can't. Fires are banned.
Same old Auntie Dillis. Never one to let authority come between her and what her wants.
This is Frederick. Mr. Evans' son, Frederick.
And that's Mr. Johnny. He says leave it to you.
In the whole wide world, in the whole universe.
Gobble, gobble.
Don't you think so, Albert?
Gobble, gobble! Gobble, gobble! Jiggity poofla!
Stop it!
Push them back. Come back!
No! No!
Come on, Nick, help me!
Look at that madman did to me! He ought to be locked up. Vicious loony like that.
Look who's coming.
Well, Frederick. Still playing the bully boy, are you?
It was only a bit of a joke, Auntie Dillis.
I don't see anyone laughing. Enjoying your time in the army?
It's good, yeah.
What will you do afterwards when the war is over? Come back to the grocery shop?
Who knows?
Well, Miss Lovely Eyes, enjoying burning all my unwanted things.
I love this dress.
Pale grey silk with pink ostrich feathers. Remember?
The last one before you...
Things are seldom as bad as you think they're going to be. Not when you come to them. So it's a waste of time being afraid. You remember that. All cleared away now. Tidied up and done with. And you remember the other thing too. What to say to my brother.
What do you mean this place is too narrow?
The town. The valley.
Well, compared to Africa, maybe. But this is your future, son.
I don't know. Things have changed. I've seen how other people do things.
You get what you work for, son. You remember that.
How the bloody hell did you put up with him?
When away a boy, comes back a man. What do you want?
Last night, Mrs. Gotobed passed away in her sleep.
Shop is closed. Understood? Closed.
Did it hurt her much? Dying?
Hepzibah said it was just like putting a lighter at the end of a day.
I keep seeing the screaming skull. And then Mrs. Gotobed's face. What'll happen to Hepzibah? Will she have to leave Druid's Bottom? And what about Mr. Johnny?
Hang on, Miss Tragedy. Mrs. Gotobed said she was going to make a will, saying they could both stay on without paying rent as long as they wanted to. Evans will be raving mad when he finds out. I bet he's counted on it.
Her own flesh and blood. But sometimes you owe more to strangers. That was what she told me to tell Mr. Evans, when she was dead. I didn't understand. I just thought she was mad. It'll make him so happy. She knew you wouldn't mind if Hepzibah and Mr. Johnny stayed in the house. It's in her will that they can stay for life. Albert told me.
And you didn't think to tell me this earlier?
She made me promise.
You owe more to strangers.
She didn't want you to think that she'd forgotten you.
My own flesh and blood! Louisa! Louisa! Louisa!
What on earth has happened?
Snake in the grass. That viper. That witch.
I thought he'd be pleased.
I will have what's mine, even if I have to go through every court in the land.
Visitor, thanks to you. Mr. Evans has given Hepzibah and Mr. Johnny a month's notice.
But you said they could stay here.
I was wrong, it seems.
But you told me.
Yeah, and you told him, didn't you?
What's happened? Tell me.
There's no will. Evans rang the bank and her solicitor, and there's no sign of one anywhere.
Has anything been taken out of you?
Nothing.
Well, we see about that. 29 ball gowns.
One fruit year of our marriage.
I will hold you personally responsible if a single one of them goes missing. One silver hairbrush. One silver hand mirror. One crystal candlestick. Did you honestly think my sister would leave you this house?
Not the house. Just somewhere to live.
Promises are worth nothing, Miss Green, without the proper legal papers.
She told me she was going to write a will.
Not that I can find. She was always full of promises, was Dillis. From now on, I want a detailed account of everything you spend. Everything you eat. Every penny. Is that understood?
She's not going to steal anything.
What are you doing here? Who's minding the shop?
Auntie Lou and Nick. I'm sorry.
Here, finish this. I want an inventory of everything in this room. Miss Green, if you would follow me, please.
I don't understand what you mean. Nick would know. Mr. Evans does that, his false teeth. He's with Hepzibah.
Did he take something, Mr. Johnny?
Out of the jewellery box. There was an envelope in there.
Yes, when Mrs. Gotobed was showing me her favourite pearl necklace, a brown envelope.
Suppose Mrs. Gotobed got a local solicitor to make a will for her and then kept it in there, and Mr. Evans came up...
Mr. Evans wouldn't take Mrs. Gotobed's will.
If a person dies without making a will, then everything they've got goes to their nearest relatives. The house and all the jewels and all the dresses will go to Mr. Evans and Auntie Lou. Nothing to Hepzibah or Mr. Johnny. Not even the right to stay on here.
I don't believe he'd do it.
All Mr. Evans had to do to get rid of her was to take the will and destroy it.
Thank you, Carrie. So sorry to hear about your sister, Mr. Evans.
Yes, well, it's over now.
I've shortchanged her.
How much?
Sixpence.
Well, run after her, girl.
This came for you earlier, from your mother.
Quick now!
There's an attic room.
I don't want to leave.
I like it here. We'll be able to see Dad when his ship comes in.
How long have we got?
He's meeting us at Cardiff Railway Station on the 21st of November. That's just a week away.
Evans wants rid of him. He's counted every single one and...
Perhaps where are Mr. Johnny found anywhere yet?
There was a farm willing to take them, but the wife is worried that Mr. Johnny might frighten their children.
Got to help them.
There's time yet.
It's from my mum. There's so much to do.
I went to see Mr. Rees, the solicitor in the square. I sat there in the waiting room for about 10 minutes, and then I came back out. I was scared he'd laugh at me.
Wouldn't have done any good. Grown-ups only listen to grown-ups.
One day, I'm going to buy Drood's Bottom. And we can all live here together.
What'll happen to Hepzibah and Mr. Johnny? I mean, you can't just throw them out.
I've given them notice enough.
And the skull? Are you going to throw that out as well? If you do...
Is this all your old religion nonsense, Louisa? Come on. I have a little surprise for you both.
A sheath knife. This is my very best thing ever. Beautiful.
I've so loved to have a new year. So much life in the house.
That's the best cheese and onion pie I've ever had.
You made it.
I know I finished it. Could I sit with you now while you tell us the story?
Which one do you want, then? You must have heard them all.
The one about the wise woman. And the skull.
Why that one? Put that down this minute, Mr. Johnny. You're running me ragged just lately.
Look what I've got. A new knife. A real hunting knife. If you give me the skull, I'll let you look at it. Mr. Evans gave it to me, and he gave Carrie a ring.
He gave you a ring? How lovely.
It's her ring, isn't it? Her special garnet ring.
Belongs to Mr. Evans now.
He stole it.
I didn't want it. He just gave it to me.
And I'm glad he gave it to you, Carrie. And Mrs. Go-to-Bed would be glad too. If she knew.
If he took that ring, he might have taken something else.
That's enough, Albert. Carrie, my love.
Do you think Mr. Evans took the will?
I don't know. Who's to say? Maybe there never was one.
I just don't believe he could.
Of course he could. How else could it have disappeared?
But what'll happen to you and Mr. Johnny?
We'll be just fine, Carrie.
But you can't leave here. You can't. It's your home.
Home is where you make it. It's not bricks and mortar.
I'll take this back to the library.
Should this skull be broke or took, these hollow eyes will on you look. For here the skull must always lie, or house and soul will certain die.